It happened, of course, in Kenosha, Wisconsin, and this is what it looks like. So let me get rid of that. But this is the map of the intersection. You can see it took place right here at 63rd Street and Sheridan Road. And if we zoom in, you're going to see this is the parking lot that we saw in that original video. So the original video, if we back up here, now this is going to be an audio warning because the audio is going to be quite loud. But this is the parking lot. You can see here the auto service portion of this building is located here. And when we go back over to the map, we're going to then see that it really is this. We're going to throw our little man here and hop down over onto Street View. And you're going to see that this is the same area. So this is where Kyle was. This is where he was sort of being chased down from this area. So we saw him turn the corner right around here and then loop back around, and the shots took place in this area. So when we go into the video, we're going to see somebody was sort of kind of, there were cars parked in this parking lot area right here, and there was somebody sort of filming from this angle. When we back out, we're also going to see that there was somebody on the other side of the street. So somebody, I think, over in this area who is going to be recording just from a different angle. So you've got somebody looking from the right side, which is going to be the east side, and you've got somebody who's sort of on the north side of the parking lot who's looking southbound into that. And that matches, like I said, just what we saw. So if we're on Street View, we're going to see that all of this took place right here at that intersection. There's a lot of activity going on there. So that was the first grouping. So then the question became, well, how much time elapsed between that grouping? The reason why this is important is because if the first original threat ended and he moved on to a different sort of area, this was a different situation when he fired that second grouping of shots, you could legally say that there were sort of separate incidents. But looking at it, I don't think that's the case. Here's why. When we go back to the map, the second video that we're going to see is really, really close by. So he takes, if you remember from the first video that we talked about, he's doing a loop sort of in this area. And we're going to go through the video again here shortly. But he's looping around in this area. He comes back over to this spot when he sees that the man was shot. And he's sort of lying on the ground. He's got a bullet, I think, in his head. And he's not in a good situation. He picks up his phone to call for help. And then he starts to see sort of the crowd kind of descending upon him, and he takes off going northbound. He's heading northbound in this direction, and he runs right up this street. He keeps going for a little bit. Kyle's running, and right about here, just north of this 32 symbol right in the roadway, is where he sort of trips and he fires the additional shots that actually connect with two people, killing them. I think it actually hits a third person at that. One person is shot and really hurts his elbow. I mean, he almost, loses his elbow, his arm on that. And then somebody else is shot and they're killed right there on the scene. And so when we put our little man here and we hop down to Street View, we're going to see that this is all going to look very familiar here in a minute. So you're going to see this is the road that he is running down. So let's go back to the video footage. Let's go back to the second part of the clips. And we're going to see right here, this is the Street View portion of it. So we're looking here and you can see this little lit, looks like a gas station or something down here, as Kyle is running down the street. There he is on the ground. We're going to see this building right here, and we're going to see this fence. And when we go back to the map, we're going to see that when we come down here also. So you can see this is the fence, this is the building, right? So if we just go up a little bit further down, we turn around, we look at it, this is going to be the same lit up sign. This is going to be the same dark windows, the same fence here. You can't see any of the stuff in the background because it's too dark. But this is the area where this all took place. He didn't make it very far. He made it just about two blocks away. He was coming from this parking lot here with the auto zone or the auto repair center at this location. And then he runs up the street and he's basically stopped and tackled right here. So he doesn't even really make it a full, two blocks before the whole situation, gets even worse than it already was. So from my perspective, just, on that analysis, it seems sort of a lot more analogous to, one continuous events, right? This all happened connected. So it's going to be difficult in my mind for the prosecutor to break these things up or to say that they're two separate incidents, right? And that's important for the analysis, because if somebody's withdrawing or somebody's fleeing or if he's re-engaging in something, then this could be, you know, considered two separate offenses. This could be something where the threat ended and then it began, or it never existed to begin with. So timing is pretty important. I don't think it's going to be an issue. I don't think that that changes any of the analysis that we talked about yesterday. It's just confirming that this was all kind of one long thing. The first shooting took place. He was immediately being chased. He ran up the street and he basically never disengaged from this altercation. So it all happened very, very quickly. And it looks like he was running away from the original incident, which of course we saw in the videos.